wonderful space and to play this midday meditation for you, which will take about 45 minutes plus minus. And the piece I'll play, I like to call the well-trained tempered Shruti Box, and it's basically a dialogue between the little Shruti Box, which is a breathing box from India, which just creates a drone, and the voice and the saxophone. And my job is to sort of mediate between the two, make sure none of them get too excited, make sure the other two listen to the others. And the singing, which Michael mentioned, some people call it harmonic singing or overtone singing. When I teach it to small people, I call it rainbow singing. I told them I just once swallowed a prism when I was in New Plymouth growing up. And the white light, which is my normal voice, splits into colors. And it's really something which is intrinsic to all of us, which is why it often seems not just beautiful, but very familiar, because all of us, whether we know it or not, are producing these harmonics and overtones all the time. And it's just basically another way to look at the sound in which we can see or perceive more colors in the sound. And so the piece itself, I do migrate a little bit through the keys, and I call it a little bit of a bridge, because in the Indian music, as a saxophonist, I would play my entire life in one key, B-flat concert. Whereas we, for some strange reason, have always liked to modulate and move around the keys. And so I've tried to keep the rootedness or the real earthed overtone bass quality of these Indian approaches to the keys mixed in with our sort of harmonic flights modulating between the keys. That's the essence of this piece. And I've done it in various forms. And that's about it. Anything else to say? Another way to look at this, there's different ways to look at this piece. You can just sit back and enjoy it. But one of the ways, one of my big passions is the essence of number. And so when you hear these harmonics, you're actually listening to number that really comes alive. So these harmonics, second, the third, the fourth one, really for me are the sound of two, the sound of duality, the sound of three, or trinity, and so on. So it's another way, symbolically, it's for me one of the most powerful ways to appreciate the number which comes alive. But most importantly, just sit back and enjoy, and I hope you like the piece. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.